The next topic which we are going to study, student, is systems of classification, the most important part of taxonomy branch. Speaking about systems of classification, the very first scientist who started classifying organisms was Carolus Linnaeus. Who is Carolus Linnaeus? Father of taxonomy, founder of taxonomy. So he first started with the system of classification. He divided the organisms present on earth into two categories, and the two categories are kingdom plantae and kingdom animalia. Now, as two categories were formed, that is why the system was named as two kingdom classification. Now, speaking about this system of classification, the system of classification was rejected. Why it was rejected? Because there were many drawbacks of the system. What are the drawbacks? First of all, where is bacteria placed? Is it placed in plant or is it placed in animal? Where is amoeba placed? Is it placed in plant or is it placed in animal? So this was the confusion, that which organism is which one. It was not correctly placed in the group. That is why this system was rejected. The main reason of rejecting the system was that bacteria, protista and fungi were placed along with the plants in the kingdom plantae. Two kingdom, looking at the drawback, another scientist introduced the third kingdom, and the name of that third kingdom was Protista. The kingdom was introduced by scientist Haeckel. So now together, how many kingdoms had been formed? Three kingdoms: Plantae, Animalia, Protista. This resulted into second system. And the name of that system, according to number of kingdom, is three kingdom classification. What logic was applied by Haeckel? Haeckel applied a logic of unicellular organism. What he did, he removed all the unicellular organism from kingdom plantae, which was placed by Linnaeus, and he placed them in a separate group called as kingdom protista. So this is how it resulted into formation of three kingdom. But this system was also rejected. Why this system was rejected? Because there was a drawback in this system too. And what was the drawback? The drawback was bacteria is unicellular, amoeba is unicellular, but do they show same features? No, not at all. The features of their body is totally different. And this was the drawback. Now, after observing this kingdom keenly, third scientist introduced the fourth kingdom. And what he did in the fourth kingdom, he separated prokaryotic and eukaryotic unicellular organism. Over here, bacteria is prokaryotic and amoeba is eukaryotic. Observing this thing, third scientist, that is Copeland introduced the fourth kingdom, and this is how it resulted into formation of next system, that is four kingdom classification. Now this fourth kingdom, that is kingdom Monera, consists of prokaryotic organism. But again, in protista, unicellular fungi and amoeba was placed together. And third thing, there was no place for fungi in this system. That is why this system was also rejected. Next came the proper system of classification, that is five kingdom classification. These are the five kingdoms formed by the scientist R.H. Whittaker. R.H. Whittaker nicely divided the organism into five kingdoms. There were certain drawbacks, but that was very negligible. Keeping in mind those negligible drawbacks, this system was accepted throughout the world, because approximately 95 to 97% of the organism got proper position in the classification. So here we completed the systems of classification. Next we are going to study five kingdom classification in detail. Thank you very much, students.